Well, I think Michael D. Higgins was obviously well ahead in the opinion polls from the outset of the campaign. So, in a sense, yesterday's exit polls are not a great surprise. I think it shows resounding support for the message that he was giving to people in the campaign, which was that he has been and he will be a president for all of the people. It's a message of inclusiveness, that everybody in Ireland should be represented and represented well by their president. And I think that that's what people have voted for yesterday.
Community, I have a total respect for. If I'd been successful, I was going to suggest that we invite all of the travelling community to move into Phoenix Park for a 5-year period. Unfortunately, I'm not in that position to do that. I would encourage Michael D to do that and insist that their schools are put in there for a 5-year period so that they can get education. Education, education, education. That's the key. And, you know, the real reason that I got a bump in the polls is because I spoke out and said that, you know, Middle Ireland, they're the people that are hurting. They're the people who got absolutely nothing out of the last budget. And they're the ones that are paying all the bills. And, you know, that to me is, you know, the unfortunate thing is, you know, there's just, you know, they're not looking for handouts. They need to help up. They need helping onto the housing ladder, for example. They can't pay the school fees because the school fees are, you know, we should, and I have to start finishing my sentences, they tell me, right? But you look, they have to, we can afford it. We can give free education to children, to students in third level education. We can do that. We have $8 billion sitting in the strategic investment fund, $1.5 billion profit made by the AIB, who we bailed out for $32 billion. What better investment could there be than to invest in our children? Now, I would put a condition on it and say, yes, you'll get free education, but you have to work, you have to stay in Ireland for 5 out of the next 6 years. I don't want to pay for their education and then have them go off to Australia or New Zealand or America, you know, and we'd not get the benefit of it. But if we do that, we will then be getting a best return you could possibly imagine on our investment. No better return could you get on the $8 billion sitting in the Strategic Investment Fund. Do you know, I've got selective amnesia. You know, I can manage to forget all my bad investments, you know, and I don't. I was disappointed. I thought that I would actually win. And by the way, I haven't ruled it out yet, you know. But you have to remember, I have the experience of losing a lot of times. So when I went round and stood for the Shannon, I went round and every single councillor who told me, I'll give you a one, had given me a one, I would have won by the largest landslide in history. But what happened was, they did give me a one, they just forgot to mention that they were putting a one in front of it. So I was getting 11, you see. So but I thought, now, there's only 6 people in the race, they can't give me 2 ones. You know?
You consider pulling out of the race because you said you didn't want to be elected on the platform of being anti-Trump. If people did vote for you in that regard, how do you feel about it?
I don't think they did. I think they voted for me because the people who voted for me are the people who are the hard-working people who are paying the bills. Those are the people who voted for me, and I'm hoping that the government will sit up and listen to those people and do something about it.